Hello everyone, and welcome back to Wolf Quest 2.7.2. And we are here with a brand new heir to the Starry Skies pack, who is going to begin her own legacy here on Amethyst Mountain today, searching for a new mate. And so without further ado, you guys, let me introduce you to Usagi. Oh, and there's already an elk. Usagi, go get it, go get it. But welcome to Usagi. So she is actually one of the first children born in the first litter that Kuma and Willow had. Kuma and Willow, oh, it's already a weakened cow elk and everything. Lucky Usagi, lucky, lucky, lucky. Oh my goodness. But Kuma and Willow were our last two wolves who were in charge of the Starry Skies pack, and they did an absolutely amazing job making the family survive and carrying on the legacy, even though we had to deal with the struggles of the Sorrow of the Skies curse, where there was no sun. It was just endless night for generations. It was quite amazing, and finally one of their children managed to break that. Oh my gosh! Usagi! Usagi! Oh my gosh, there's a fox, Usagi! Okay, don't get distracted. I think she would get distracted, though, because this is her very first day kind of out on her own. We're never going to catch this guy without sneaking up on it a little bit, so let's try a new tactic. Look at this. Oh my goodness. But we're here with Usagi, and she is the one that I chose out of all of the surviving children of Kuma and Willow, and it's really, really hard, actually, to have let go of Kuma. I really love him. I'm going to miss him so much. It's going to be very, very difficult to admit that his era is over, but he had three litters. Oh my goodness. Why can't we catch this cow? Come on. Come on, elk. Come on. I need to catch you. I'm very hungry. Why do you have to be so fast? All right. Come on, Usagi. We've got this. We've got this. You're gaining on it. You're gaining on it. Don't get distracted. We've got the momentum of the hill to help us. All right. Come on. Come on. And can we get a couple good bites in? Can we get a couple good bites in? We're so close. There we go. All right. And this one, don't let go. Come on, Usagi. Come on. A little bit faster. Okay, we're gonna have to rest for a second. Oh my gosh. So this is Usagi's very first hunt, and already she is kind of showing her inexperience and the way that she's a very, very young wolf. We don't really have a lot of cover right here. Oh man. Yep, and I think we're actually on the wrong part of... Oh, we are upwind. So, of course, our scent is going to blow onto the cow elk. Oh, my gosh. But this is kind of hilarious because this is Usagi's very first hunt on her own here on Amethyst Mountain, away from her family as a lone wolf, ready to establish her own branch of the family tree. There we go. That's what we wanted. All right, Harriet, Usagi, you've got it. You've got it. A few good bites to the neck, and then you will have your very first kill. I will be so proud of you. But let me take out this cow elk, and then... All right, come on, come on. All right, food! Good job, Usagi. Her very first hunt of her own, and we'll go ahead and let her get some food. But she's the one I picked, because if you recall, a lot of our wolf pups are often born with special abilities, and Usagi has been given the special ability granted to her from the Starry Sky Pack ancestors, which include both the Stormy Skies and the Moon Pack, to be able to get an ancestor blessing for each of the full set of rabbit's feet she manages to collect. So if she manages to get four rabbits, to kill all four rabbits somewhere out in the world and collect up their lucky rabbit's feet, when she gets a set of four, she will get an ancestor blessing, which is really good because we currently are completely out of ancestor blessings. And if you have no idea what the heck an ancestor blessing is or what I'm talking about, ancestor blessings are special things that we earn through our wolves doing something great in the world, showing their prowess, their intelligence, their strength, their endurance, by meeting challenges that are given to them by their ancestors, the ancestor wolves who have gone before us, basically. All right, let's see. Can I see anything with scent view? What? Scent view is not working. What? That's not right. That's not right at all. Okay, hopefully it'll be working later. Usagi, don't tell me you have a broken nose because of a glitch. That would be kind of hilarious, though. We're actually working our way over to the hunting grounds here in the forest, where little Usagi is probably hoping to find more elk. So we'll let her kind of catch her breath for a second, and then we'll try looking around. I might have to reload so that her nose will work. So we'll let her take a little nap here in the shade, and then I will explain a little bit more to you guys about ancestor blessings, why we use them, how we have enhanced Wolf Quest so many times with so many different challenges that we've turned it into almost an entirely new game. Oh, did she find the elk? I hear the elk. I don't see the elk. But the reason I chose Usagi was because of her special ability, the ability to be able... I don't see the elk anywhere. Ah, there they are. There they are. All right, let's try to hunt them down. but the ability to earn ancestor blessings through chasing down the rabbits. Rabbits kind of pop up at random. It used to be you could find bunny bushes, but I've never had luck finding said rumored bunny bush. And let's see, is there a weekend cow elk? What about the one that has spinny doos right there in the center of the herd? All right, oh, that one's definitely a weakened one because she took off. All right, well, I think Usagi is kind of relying on her speed more than her stealth. Let's see if we can catch up with this elk. If we just sort of aim ourselves directly at it, hopefully we'll be able to catch up with her and start biting her rump. Come on, Usagi, you've got this. You've got speed on your side. And that's the other reason that I chose Usagi, is that she's a very, very fast wolf. And I seem to do much better with the fast wolves than anything else. And it looks like she drops immediately into the shadows to kind of recover her stamina for a second. All right, and then let's do this. Chase the elk, chase the elk. We've got it. All right, and then we'll do one bite, two bite, and then hang on this third bite, Usagi. And we'll use up the rest of our stamina. There we go. So, and then she'll drop into the shadows and start sneaking again. That's a pretty good tactic. We seem to be getting this. We'll just have to like sneak between these patches of grass and try to catch up to the elk. But what we need to do on Amethyst Mountain with Usagi is start stretching her legs for the first time as an adult wolf. And that's really going to help her out. Okay, come on, come on, come on, elk. It's really going to help her out to prepare her for the challenges ahead of raising her own pack of wolves. And she needs to get her strength up for that, and she definitely needs to find a mate of her own. She right now is a very young and somewhat silly wolf, which is another reason I kind of like her. She reminded me a lot of her dad, Kuma, because she's a little bit sillier. And Kuma, of course, reminds me of the great-great-great-grandfather Atlas, and I've always got a soft spot in my heart for Atlas. All right, oh, there we go. Good job, Usagi. She's actually doing a lot better on trying to take down the cow elk than I thought she would, too. But it seems like she prefers hunting from the shadows, which is another family trait for Nightlight, if you remember Nightlight. There we go. There we go. And let's go ahead and eat up this cow elk and kind of recover our stamina for a moment. All right, good. There. So yes, basically Usagi comes from a very long line and a very long family of wolves, because we have over 200 episodes of Wolf Quest by now, you guys, and we have worked really, really hard to be able to achieve that, and I'm really proud of the history. So a lot of the history is tied up in Wolf Quest, but if you just want to know what a fresh start that we're doing with this brand new wolf is, Usagi's goal here on Amethyst Mountain is actually to go and look at each of the three different wolf territories to try to find a potential mate for herself. She is looking for a male wolf that she can take back after she finds him from one of these territories to the traditional family territory where she's going to raise her children over in the creek area. Well, to get to the creek, we first have to have a mate. And to get a mate, you have to have enough points. So you have to earn enough experience. It's about 3,000 experience, if I remember correctly. And so Usagi needs to gain a lot more. I think maybe it's 1,500, something in that range. It's definitely more than 200. We just need to keep going. And she needs to go and hunt down different elk. She needs to be able to maybe take out some coyotes, maybe find some lucky rabbits, aka the hares, to be able to eat, chase off some grizzlies, chase off cougars. All of those things will actually give her experience points and make her more experienced as a wolf and ready to start her own pack. Right now, she's very young and inexperienced, and her family is actually in shock. I think that Kuma and Willow sort of retired from leading their pack and decided to go into new lands further up north when the sun came back, because her parents were raised during a time of total darkness when there was a curse on the entire wolf pack. And we're looking for more. Ah, there we go. Now scent view is working again. Whoa, lots of dead elk over here. Oh my goodness. I thought this for a second was like a giant skull on the ground. That was interesting. So there's a dead elk over here. Very interesting. Very interesting indeed. And we might search for where the trail of elk went just a second ago so we can hunt down another one and get more experience. I think Usagi really does prefer... Oh, are the elk somewhere nearby? Really does prefer the shadows and the bushes and the forest. Where on earth did those elk go? Let's see. I don't see them just yet. We're in scent view right now, which should allow us to pick up the elk scent if they're anywhere nearby. But I don't know if they are. So let's head out of the elk territory and we may be able to stumble on the herd wandering along the edges. Sometimes they'll come along the edges of the forest here. All right, so we'll guide her this way and maybe try zipping back into elk territory. In fact, let's go over to this spot over here because this little area tends to have cougars or stray elk or foxes that sometimes we stumble on. We did stumble on that fox earlier, which was very interesting. But yes, to make Wolf Quest more interesting, because we have done hundreds of episodes of Wolf Quest, we actually have made it so that we have multiple challenges, and that refers to the Ancestor Blessings earlier. Ancestor Blessings allow you to reload an autosave if you lose a wolf. So if your main wolf ends up dead, what normally happens then is we would have to abandon that entire line and go to a new branch of the family tree, or immediately move on to one of the earlier surviving pups of that line. So if Usagi had two litters, but she died trying to raise the second litter, and we didn't have any ancestor blessings, then we would have to go back to her first litter and pick the new heir from that, when traditionally we do about three litters per wolf, so that they can have a chance to have lots of puppies and lots of adventures. All right, let's see. Anything over here? Sometimes there'll be something interesting up by these rocks. And I have a feeling Usagi is actually exceptionally curious. So she is our curious rabbit, and she also... Oh, there we go! Coyote! See? Alright, we need to chase down the coyote, which may seem a little bit weird. But she's very curious, and she's got to learn how to fight the coyote. And I know this seems odd, but that's actually... See, that's experience points right there. So we actually have to fight those coyotes in order to gain experience points, even though it seems a little brutal. But that, my friends... Oh, the creepy music came back. I have no idea where that music's from, but occasionally it'll pop in from Lost River too. All right, let's zigzag through these sagebrush. Oh, I hear the birds. That's so cool. Oh my gosh. All right, so yes. If we had to move on to the next generation, that would happen if we ran out of ancestor blessings. Ancestor blessings, we say, are just the ability to turn a death of a pup, which often happens, pups drowning, pups getting eaten by another predator, pups starving to death. If that happens and we have ancestor blessings, we're able to go ahead and reload from the autosave and see if we're able to save the pup and move on. And to earn ancestor blessings, each lead wolf who's in charge of being heir of that generation has to meet certain challenges. Usagi's special, special challenges are actually these bunnies! How perfect is this? Oh my gosh, yes! Okay, so this little bunny, gotcha! This little bunny is actually Usagi's challenge to gather up lucky rabbit's feet, and she just got one of them! This is fantastic! We're gonna have to eat it so that we can say, there we go, she's collected the lucky rabbit's foot. If she finds three more bunnies, then she gets her first ancestor blessing. And we used up the ancestor blessings last time to actually end the curse, the Sorrow of the Skies curse, which is pretty useful. So yes, there's several layers to the stories that we've done. I'll try to post a comment in the video so that I can kind of summarize what our current wolf is, what their current goals are, so it's not quite as confusing for if you're brand new to the series and you're like, what the heck's happening with all of these things? What are you talking about? But trust me, it makes things a lot more interesting and a lot more tense because we have done the challenge before. Oops. All right, there's elk. There's been elk here 7 minutes ago. All right, is there elk up here? No, this is 8 minutes ago. Turn around. All right. Oh, that scent was so faint. It already vanished. We were so close to finding more elk. Okay, let's see. All right, that's what we're looking for in scent view, is those little dots, and that will lead us to the elk. It's been so long, I'm not sure how many of you I need to like go through Wolf Quest 101 again with or not, but I guess that's what we have 200 previous episodes for. All right. So yes, that's Usagi's challenge to earn ancestor blessings is actually being able to take out four hares and get a lucky, like the four lucky rabbit's feet, get an ancestor blessing. There they are! Why didn't you guys have scent view? Have you learned how to mask your scent? That wouldn't be very good. All right, we're gonna sneak up on them. Let's see if we can find one of the weaker ones again. Oh, and is it gonna rain? Wonderful. The rain, actually, we usually say is a gift from the Starry Skies ancestors. It'll be those two around the other side, I think. And we're not going to take on the bull elk because he will just flatten us, I believe. All right, let's come over here. I'm pretty sure it's going to be one of these ladies who's feeling kind of weak. Yeah, right there. We've got a good one lined up in our sights. They will start running if we get a little bit closer. All right. What about you? Are you weak? Nope. Okay. So we want this one right here. And ready for it. Go. All right, let's chase her down. She'll be another little boost of experience, which will be wonderful. So Usagi seems to be really figuring out the forest hunting, and I feel like that's where she's most comfortable because of all of these shadows. She was raised in total darkness with the night sky always being out, so I feel like it makes sense that she would prefer to be a wolf of the shadows, even if she is a silly, curious little thing. I think she's very curious, and that's really going to benefit her. But in the past, we've only given our wolves like a perk, where they could earn ancestor blessings if they do X amount of things. And I think I want to start balancing that out by giving each of our wolves a fault as well. And so Usagi's fault is going to be anytime she runs into a cougar, she must fight the cougar. There's something about her that just seems a little bit weaker than your usual wolf because she's a bit smaller. She's extremely fast, but a lot of cougars usually only need one hit to be able to take out their prey. They're stealth predators that might be able to take out their prey with like one good attack. So there's something about Usagi that seems a little bit weaker that makes cougars very, very curious about her. And so anytime we run into a cougar, which is something that often happens at night especially, then we will have to go ahead and fight that cougar. And if we have to fight the cougar and she survives, then we still have to roll a dice. And if she rolls a 6 after fighting a cougar, she has taken a severe blow. And if she does not have an ancestor blessing, then she could probably die. So we need to have an ancestor blessing or else she'll die from her fight with the cougar if she rolls a 6, even if she wins the fight. And that's a really heavy fault, though we don't run into too many. Where are all those elk? I hear them, but I can't see them. We don't usually run into too many cougars, but those are our first set of challenges. So I'll explain the next set next time, because there's a lot more to it, because every litter, every generation, or every litter that we do, we also have a challenge for that litter. And Usagi has a very, very interesting one. But I will explain that next time because there's enough challenges. Like I said, it's layer on layer of challenges. And I think one of the first challenges is going to be the fact Usagi's nose doesn't seem to work very well because I can't find... Oh, another coyote. Get out of here. Get out of here. That's mine. That's my rotting, my rotting carcass. Get out of here, coyote. All right. So she seems fast enough to easily take on coyotes, which is a good thing. But we're going to have to learn a little bit more about this curious wolf's personality and how she likes to roam either the forest or the plains, the open areas or the shadowed spots and the undergrowth next time. And I will definitely... Hey, back off. Back off. Shoot, ravens. Shoot. We're going to have some of this. This is mine. This is my elk carcass. But we will definitely figure out what she's like, and we'll start taking on the unique challenge that we have to do in meeting, greeting, possibly fighting, or possibly befriending each of the three wolf packs next time. So I'll see you guys then. Bye-bye.